Welcome, my dear friends, to tonight's magical bedtime story. My name is Jacob Evans, and tonight you are invited to journey into a secret hidden garden where emotions bloom into glowing flowers, and the moonlight dances gently on ancient oak branches. As you step into this mystical garden, the air is filled with a soft, fragrant breeze, carrying the scent of blooming roses and the warmth of the earth beneath your feet. The soft glow of lanterns and the hum of nature surround you, inviting you to release the weight of the day and find peace in this enchanted place. Let the gentle presence of the garden, the shimmer of ethereal flowers, and the soft touch of moonlight soothe your heart and mind. You've done enough today, my friend. Truly, it is enough. Rest now as I stay with you, my voice guiding you gently, keeping watch as the magic of the garden cradles you into serene and restful dreams. As the line between the ordinary and the magical fades, take a deep breath. Close your eyes. And let's walk together into this quiet, forgotten garden. The moon hung low over the forest as Lyra wandered through the trees, her heart heavy with the weight of her past. She had left her village that evening, seeking solace in the woods, her mind filled with thoughts of the one who had wronged her. It had been years, yet the hurt still pulsed within her like a fresh wound. She had tried everything, distance, time, distractions, but nothing could lift the bitterness that hung to her soul. As she walked, the forest seemed to grow denser. The trees leaning closer together as if whispering secrets only they could understand. A soft mist curled around her feet, and the air felt thicker, laced with a strange energy. Lyra hesitated, unsure of where her feet were taking her. But then, just ahead, she caught sight of a faint glow, a warm, golden light filtering through the trees. drawn to the light, Lyra pushed aside the branches and stepped into a clearing she had never seen before. The air here was different, calmer, almost dreamlike. Before her lay a garden, hidden away from the world. Flowers of every color and shape filled the space. Their petals shimmering as though they were made of stardust. Soft, glowing pathways wove between them, leading deeper into the magical garden. At the center of it all stood an ancient oak tree, its branches spreading wide, casting a protective canopy over the garden. Lanterns hung from the branches, glowing with a gentle light that danced with the rhythm of the breeze. The garden seemed alive, humming with a soft melody that soothed her soul. "Welcome, Lyra." Startled, Lyra turned to see a figure standing at the edge of the garden. The figure was cloaked in robes of green and gold, their face serene and kind. In their hands, they held a simple wooden staff, and their eyes twinkled like the stars above. "Who are you?" Lyra asked, her voice barely a whisper. "I am the gardener," the figure replied. "This is the Forgotten Garden, a place where the heart's deepest emotions bloom. You have been drawn here because your soul is seeking something, perhaps a gift you are not yet aware of." Lyra looked around, her gaze landing on a rose bush near the center of the garden. The roses were unlike any she had ever seen, deep crimson with thorns that gleamed in the moonlight. Yet there was one rose at the heart of the bush, larger than the rest. Its petals closed tight as if waiting for something. "The thorned rose," the gardener said softly. "It is the most precious flower in the garden. But it only blooms for those who are ready to release the burdens they carry." Lyra frowned. How does a flower know anything of burdens? The the gardener smiled, stepping closer to the rose bush. This garden thrives on emotions. Every flower here grows from the feelings of those who find their way to this place. Joy, sorrow, anger, love. They are all part of the garden's life. But the thorned rose represents forgiveness, the rarest and most powerful of all. Lyra felt a knot tighten in her chest. Forgiveness. How could I forgive? The pain is too deep. The gardener touched the rosebush gently, their hand brushing over the thorns without flinching. Forgiveness is not about erasing the hurt or excusing what has been done. It is about releasing yourself from the weight of the pain. You do not forgive for the other, you forgive for yourself. Lyra stared at the rose. Its tightly closed petals, seemingly locked in place. She could feel the truth of the gardener's words. But the idea of letting go felt impossible. Like asking her heart to fly while it was still chained to the earth. Come, the gardener said, gesturing to a small stone bench under the oak tree. Sit with me for a while. Let the garden speak to you. Lyra followed, sitting beside the gardener as the gentle hum of the garden filled the silence between them. The scent of flowers surrounded her, soothing her frayed nerves. And for a moment, she simply breathed in the peace of the place. As they sat, the gardener spoke again, their voice soft and comforting. The thorned rose is like the heart. It blooms when it is ready, but only when the thorns of pain are embraced and released. It's not an easy task, but forgiveness is a gift, one that is meant to be given. Lyra closed her eyes, feeling the weight of the words sink into her soul. She thought of the person who had hurt her, the years of anger and resentment she had carried, and how they had weighed her down. The pain was real, but was it worth the burden she had been holding on to for so long? Slowly, she rose from the bench and walked toward the rose bush. The thorned rose seemed to glow in the moonlight. Its petals still closed, the thorns sharp and gleaming. Lyra reached out, her fingers brushing against the thorns. They pricked her skin, but she didn't pull away. Instead, she closed her eyes and let the pain wash over her. Not the pain of the thorns, but the pain she had carried for so long. In that moment, she felt something shift within her. The bitterness, the anger, the hurt, they began to loosen their grip. It wasn't sudden or dramatic, but it was enough. Enough for her to understand that holding on to the pain had only hurt her more. Enough for her to realize that forgiveness was not about the other person. It was a gift she needed to give herself. As she opened her eyes, the thorned rose began to bloom. Its petals slowly unfurled, revealing a heart of soft, glowing light. The thorns seemed to soften, their soft edges dulling as the flower bloomed in full. The garden filled with a soft, warm glow. And Lyra felt her heart lighten, as if the weight she had carried for so long was finally lifting. The gardener stood beside her, their eyes filled with quiet approval. "You have given yourself the gift of forgiveness, Lyra. Now, you can give it to others." Lyra nodded, feeling a sense of peace she hadn't known was possible. As she turned to leave the garden, the gardener's final words lingered in the air like a soft breeze that carried hope and healing. Forgiveness is forgiving. So give yourself this gift from time to time. With the moonlight guiding her path, Lyra walked out of the forgotten garden, her heart lighter than it had ever been. The world felt softer, kinder, and for the first time in years, a smile born not of joy alone, but of release and the quiet, healing power of forgiveness.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.